Greetings of the day. Welcome to the HR session. Please like and subscribe my channel. In the today's session, we are going to discuss about the science of OB. What is the mastery of the science of OB? I hope the previous sessions were clearly understood, and in case of any sort of a query, please inform me. Now, the science of OB. What is actually the science of OB? It is very important to understand. Learning about the organization behavior, which includes basically the three activities which is shown in this diagram, that is the objective knowledge, skill development, application of knowledge and skill, right? So organization behavior, otherwise it is based on the scientific knowledge and the applied practice. It involves basically the study of abstract ideas, expectancy, valence, motivation. Also, as well as it is the study of your complete, you know, concrete matters. So, like concrete matter means observable behaviors, your any kind of medical symptom, right? Distress at work. Okay, so if I talk about this mastery of certain body, that is objective knowledge, skill development, application of the knowledge and skill, so which is based on knowledge, understanding of the mastery of abilities leads to the success. So learning is challenging. On the other side, it is surely a fun too. So, which is totally and totally altogether different. Many options are there. So, let us find out what it is. Because in case if I talk about the teaching and learning style, so my dear friends, my dear students, teaching and learning styles, they are aligned very carefully. Educators, they must be aware of, you know, teaching is not only, or what I can say, it is no longer merely of reading and verbal and visual. So it is now become virtual too. Use of charts, use of maps, PowerPoint presentations, videos, games, internets, flashcards, writing things, many things are included in it. The need is to, you know, merge or a combination or a cone of all these stuff is there to make a good ice cream. So what is basically this objective knowledge? Objective knowledge is the field of study which is developed through basic applied research. It is a research in the organization behavior which continued, and the research on the scientific management and acquiring of any objective knowledge which requires the cognitive mastery of theories on scientific management or conceptual models, research findings. So this is your the research of organization behavior. Mastering of the subject ideas which comes from the notes, which enables you to intelligently discuss the topics like motivation, performance, leadership. Okay, so all these are the objective knowledge. Okay, so in case if I talk about, if I make you more clear on this point, then it is to think critically about the objective knowledge in the organization behavior, that is only by engaging in critical thinking. Can one question or one can challenge the results of scientific research and consider how to apply the research results in particular work setting. So rote memorization doesn't prepare the students to appreciate the complexity of theories or the intricacies of interrelated concept, idea and topic. So in this, good critical thinking, however, enable student to identify inconsistencies and limitations in current body of objective knowledge. So critical thinking, what it is? It is basically based on knowledge, understanding of basic idea, and which leads to executive exploration. Key to accepting and responsibility of co-producer of the learning process. So I hope it is clear. Next is your skill development. Now, skill development is group can't learn for its member. It is very clear. So learning about the organization behavior requires doing as well as knowing. So do and know. So the development of skills, abilities require students to be challenged by the instructor, either through quizzes or through some questions or through some some case studies. Okay, so this is the part of this which includes the essential skills which are identified with this is resource management skill, information management skill, time management, personal interaction, system behavior, performance skills, cause and effect relationship skill, means problem solving skill, technology utilization skill, and so on. So these are the strategy of organization behavior. So developing the skill is different from acquiring. This is very much correct. No? Developing is different from acquiring knowledge, objective, because it requires the structure, practice, and feedback. And it is the function of experimental learning is engaging the student in individual or in the group activity. So the process for learning from structure or experimental activities, it is through gaining new modified knowledge and skill. So if I say the skill development or the structure learning occurs in this way, so there should be self-correcting element that to the learning, because modification of the student learning or modification of the student knowledge and skill is over time. Okay, so another one is, means consensus group decisions are better if there is a modification in the learning, as well as in knowledge or in the skill. So next is application of knowledge and skill. So otherwise, I hope it is clear that in the skill development, firstly, we are going to develop the skill, and one thing I forget to tell you, that in the skill development, how it is possible, to develop it. See, development is with the help of, definitely first is that everyone's responsibility is to develop themselves own at their own, right? Because group can't learn for its member. This is very right. Now, every member is himself or herself is responsible to learn, right, and to develop. Number two is where each member should actively participate, or some group structure learning activity to be there, right? Group structure activity to be there. Third one is that each member should be open to new information, new skill. It is not that I am in that boundaries and I am not interested to learn something new or some new skill, right? So new skill, new ideas, new experiments, this is required. And open attitude to learn, to adjust, that is also required. So this is your skill development. Now is application of knowledge and skill, where you understand the organization behavior, includes an appreciation, understand the working realities, right, science and yourself. So now is the point to, instead of losing the temperament in the classroom activity, create a comparatively safe environment to accept the new behavior, and create that kind of situation energetic situation, new learning styles where everyone to engage safe and engage their brains to form the abstract hypothesis. So that is very important, and definitely reach towards the concrete hypothesis, concrete experience. So this is the part of this application. Okay, so it is an applied science where student is not trained in the organization behavior, rather educated in the education this organization behavior. But distinguish in the both is definitely the degree of direct or the immediate applicability of knowledge skill. So education enhances person pool of objective knowledge skill, and then that rather the selectively application to that particular thing. So this is the lifelong learning about this organization behavior. So I hope this much is clear to all of you. And in the next topic, I am going to cover that the various levels of analysis of organization behavior, individual level, group level, and the organization level, and how it is beneficial, and how we can understand these level of analysis, and with understanding these level of analysis, how an employer or a boss or a manager can utilize the knowledge, skill, and the ability effectively to attain the organization goal. Thank you for attending the session, and please subscribe my channel, like my channel, and in case any topic required to be framed, I am here to support. Thank you.